cold front crappie in spring. I'm going to show you how I fish them with the slip bobber and little shad bait. We're going to pick a little back bait. That's the warmest water we can find. In springtime, those crappies get right in that stuff here up in Ontario, Texas, and Oklahoma and stuff. There's different areas, different ways they fish for them, single poling. You know, they still use a float, but it's a very popular technique and presentation to catch them. We set it up with a slip float here, and you got a little bobber stop that you put on, so it affects how far up the float will go up, then that affects how deep you're fishing. So that there is about 24 inches, okay? The area I'm gonna be fishing is about 4.5, between 3 to about 5 feet, I'd say. So about 4.5 feet. So I'm gonna start with the float, a little deeper, about 36 inches. And I'm vary that depending on the bites, the depth I'm at. I always wanna keep this little bait above the crappie's face so he sees it. I don't like to have to make them go down. They will eat down, but I like to have them just look up and go boom, and grab it. Little shad baits I'm gonna use just look like real small little profile. 1/16 ounce jig heads. Maybe they decide to come along this shoreline up here. Yep. Oh my God, dude. Whoa, look at, he's still got another one. Wow, black and gold, dude. Oh yeah, that's it. Oh, the one I just missed, my first crappie of the year, was a tank. It looked like a giant crappie. Look at the little lips. Little plastic. First little one of the year. First trip of the year. Cold front. Like, I mean, it was 70 degrees yesterday. Today, it's like 40. But anyhow, we'll let them go. Let me show you how it's going to be. Plastics and little bobbers. In a little back bay. My favorite poles. Favorite spot. And favorite species in spring, black crappies. How can you beat it? Man, the first one I seen turn, it all was all gold, all the bottom. And as soon as it settled, it went to the right already. Like a kid again fishing. That's what crappies do. There's one. Oh boy, what are you? Well, it's crappie. Man, little males, huh? Good eating size fish. Boy, oh boy. 10, 11 inch. Look at that. Just gorgeous little fish. Let them go. You want to find one of those big mamas. Let's just keep going. Let's try to find a big mama. And I know what you're thinking. Oh yeah, sure, the first one he lost was a giant. But I saw the whole turn. It looked like a plate. But that's how it goes. Just having fun. There's another one. Ay, ay, ay. Man, oh man. Here's the deal. Lighter rod. This rod I got is a 7.6. How long that is? So I make those easy underhand pitches. Because I got only 1/16 ounce little jig. Small little plastic bait, little shad bait, bright chartreuse with white. And I see how I got that slip bobber, and it's about, oh, I'd say 30 inches probably from where the bait goes. So it slides up, and I put an extra little split shot on here just so the bait gets down faster. It doesn't take time, get right back down where they are. So the bobber will sit straight. A lot of times crappie eat, when they hit upwards, the float goes this way. So I want that float not to be sitting like this. You know, I might miss that. But when it's totally vertical like this and they come up and eat it, the float will go boop. As soon as it sits sideways, set hook. So let's try it. We're in the right spot. Let's catch some crappie. Get that little bait. See a little tail on it? So when I'm casting out working areas, I don't let it sit for a long time. These fish will tell you real quick if they're there. Cast, let it settle. Float sits vertical, twitch, twitch, and down. What's happening is every time you twitch, the little bait goes up and down, up, down. That little tail. See what happens when I move it? It shakes. When it shakes, that's when they eat it. Come on, crappie. That's a good fish, dude. If that's a crappie, seriously? No, this is good, good. If it's a crappie, it is too. Oh boy. Wow, man. Come on. Just stay, stay, stay. Stay. Oh my goodness me. Someone says plates. Put out the dinner plate. I might call this one dinner plate crappie. Why? Look at that, man. Look at that. I know you get those giants in Mississippi and Oklahoma and Texas, but that's what we catch right here in Ontario. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous fish? Take some pictures of some fish and maybe have a meal, but right there, that's what I'm looking for. Let's put her in here, huh? Go in here, right, girl? For a swim. Plastics, bobbers, and fun. Sit back up, get some more. What's really important is you have enough weight, like a little split shot here, 1/16th ounce jig head. So it's, sometimes it's not enough weight to make that float to sit totally vertical. Crappie fishing, it's so important to have your float vertical, because a lot of times they'll come up, doop, when it goes flat like that, set hook, because nothing else does it other than a crappie. So he comes up to it, sees it, inhales it, doop, float goes sideways, you set. But make sure you have enough weight that the water level is about halfway, three quarters away, so all you see is a little bit of orange on top of the water. It's very sensitive to pull under, so they don't feel any resistance. But when it's totally vertical like that, and a crappie bites, and it just goes under nice and slow, that's easy to see. But sometimes they hit it, it goes this way, set hook. Along clumps, that's what they're in right there. There's shallow clumps up there. There's one right there. Oh boy. No, male? He ain't fighting at all. Oh, now he can put some splash. Isn't that a gorgeous sight when you see the water splashing like that for crappies? I mean, that traditional come to the surface and splash their tail and all their fins. You're just a small guy, but she's getting a bit of a belly on her. Let's put it right back in that same spot. See if we can't provoke a 16 incher. So peaceful, listen to it. Wow. There's a good one right there, dude. Uh-oh. I think that's... Come on, splash. Now she's splashing. Oh, boy. Hey. Wow, do I ever... love crappie. Oh man, look at that, look at that. Watch this, ready? See where that hook is? Look at that membrane, man. How they just slice it. And those real big ones come off like that. Again, that's just a good eater, but I might catch a few, take home for dinner, have a small meal, but I'm looking for the big ones. And it's so hard to beat springtime with a bobber before they get real tight. When they get real tight, I like to hunt, pick up that long pole, individual fish, clumps, trees, bushes, rocks, and stuff like that. But it's so hard to beat a little plastic bait, small jig head, sliding bobber along the shallows and clumps, catch them in spring. You see it works, man, and it's very popular. Let's catch another one. Okay, it's first week of May. Water temperatures back here are like 54 degrees. On the main lake, 42, 43. So it's imperative in this little back bays with black bottom, silty, old leaves and branches and wood and stuff, it heats up faster. So 42 degrees out in the main lake, 43. Back in here, 54, 56. And I think that by the time the afternoon comes, 1, 2 o'clock, when the sun stays high, it's away from the wind, if it gets up to around 57, 58, they're going to be on fire. I don't know if that was branches that I hit. Nope. Whoa. Oh, did there be crappie on that tree? I want to save that for single poling fishing, but when you're catching them, decent little fish, little pans, eh? They're like round. They're not long, these crappie. They're like round. You know, they're not long. Beautiful little fish. Fix up my float. I got the poles down and just push it up against that little 1/16th ounce jig head. Let's keep going. Let's see how many I can catch right here. and knew that first one was a bite. Oh, I'm not caught. I'm moving. Dang. Gotta be right on that imaginary line. Like right on that line where they come out almost, oh, right there. That's single poling at its best right there. Put in a 12-foot pole, dissect it, and just catch them all. Right there. Oh, missed them. I'm gonna pole down. Sit right in this spot right here. Oh, no. Whoa, lucky. Man, they'll congregate right up and tighten that tree. Best part is a tree like that can keep loading up all day long, dude. All day long. You know what? It's too shallow. Or I mean, I'm too deep. See that grass I got in the bottom? I don't know if that was from that branch, but I think that's only like, 2.5 feet deep. And I want to stay above the fish's head. So I'll just shorten it up a little bit by about 5 inches. Let's try the outside edge here. Right on that tip of the tree there. Yep. Oh, good one too. Whoa, where are you going? Hey? They're almost like all twins in here. Look at it. It's the 11-inch club. 11 inches of crappie. Black and gold. Hey? Just good eating size crappies right there, boy. You know them big ones I like to catch and take pictures of, but those right there. So here's what I'm doing here too, because that tree's tapering down. In this channel, I'm sitting in 4 feet of water. So obviously the deeper edges, they like to see this deeper stuff here. If I was single poling, I bet I can get them way up inside there, but holding the pole right down right below the surface. But these ones that are eating the little plastic, they're right on the tip of this tree at the deepest section, at the point of it right there. Let's see if there's any more there. And they bury right in. When they eat it, they turn right around and try to go right back in there. You can almost feel the brush sometimes when I'm fighting them. See? Wow, eh? Look how they scrap. Wow. Man, wildlife catching crappies, man. I just love it. Look where he's got it here too. Look at that. Huh? Right through the side, past the membrane. Getting a sharp little jig hook right there. That's right there. A little bit more than a handful. Ready? Go on. Little shad bait. Just a little shad bait. Streamlined little thing with a little tail. And you can see how it just shakes in the water when I shake it. I just shake it, you know? Get it up straight, line it up, a little tail, even the wind, it's moving and stuff. Little white jig head, right to the hook. Can't beat it. Yeah, chartreuse. A little bit of glare there, it's like, woof. We're catching fish right there. Pulls down. Are you crappie or are you gill? Big crappie, oh boy. Wow, man, a little shad bait. I changed it up to a little chartreuse or orange with chartreuse. Nice little slab. Whoa, man, that's a nice looking fish. That's the ones right there. That's the ones right there. Keep mama happy. Easy fillet. One in there. Let's put it back in there. See if my little bobber can go. How many fish are there? Hey, how many? Let's catch a few. Pop, pop, fizz. Why don't you leave them alone for a bit and come back? That is black crappie. You see that? Out a bit further. Oh, nice one too. Oh, wow. Wow. Bobbers and shad baits. Wow. Right in the hard part where it's like, you know, he's coming in the boat. Tell me that's not fun, eh? Seeing that little float just twitch, boom. So I caught some different species, caught some pike, and all of a sudden, the crappies decide to wake up. And that's the thing with crappie fishing. You get one going, it's like the whole school decides, hey man, there's minnows here, let's eat them. Can I pull another one out of here? How many got stung mouths? How many went back? Yep. Whoa. Oh boy. Walter was in there. Look at. On the outside edge, man. Oh, eating the soft shad bait. Look at that. Is that a handful or what? Wow. Tell me that isn't fun crappies, man. Right past the membrane. That's why I use those jig heads that are a little bit more set back. I'll take a few pictures of that one. We'll let her go. But man, oh man. Got the poles down. Casting to it. I pulled her off there. Or him off. Let's see. No. Look at the skinny little belly. That's a male. So be patient. Keep moving around. Stay on the trolling motor. Look down the sonar. Watch your depths and stuff. Remember where you caught the first fish. 3 to 5 feet of water. And keep replicating that in the same areas you are. And you'll keep catching them just like this. There you have it. An afternoon. Now slip bobbers and small little plastic baits, catching crappies like there's no tomorrow, in a few little pods, some jack of all trades, one here, one there. We found a little pocket of fish, caught some fish, had some fun. Think of the plastics, think of the bobbers, think of crappie.